Hi there, and welcome to another Film Impact video. I'm Jaap Harmboerhoff. I'm the founder and senior developer of Film Impact Premium Tools, and I'm here to show you what's new in version 4.5. Now, we've got three new tools ready for you. And the first one to start off is the Light Sweep Impact. And this is designed to accentuate logos, to highlight edges, and give it a very cool beam across the logo, and that will just grab the attention of the viewer's eyes and just highlight elements and see how the embossing effect here is happening. That's just beautiful. We're gonna dive into this effect in a moment. Let's show you the second new tool we've got. It's the panel wipe, and it adds layers of glass panels, and that's beautiful, right? So and finally, we've redone the glitch. So we've added a lot of more controls and add a beautiful way to do a glitch. And this is a very interesting effect. It can be applied to text, logos, footage, whatever. So let's dive in straight away to the Light Sweep Impact. And to show you and demonstrate you this, I have a barbershop logo sitting right here. And to accentuate a logo, I'm just gonna make a cut in the center, somewhere where you want to add the extra attention to this particular logo. And then I'm gonna look for the light sweep. And applying it is as easy as drag and drop. So drag, drop, and there you go. Oh, that's beautiful. Let's give it more room to breathe. And this is very nice on accentuating this particular logo. And let's click the transition and check out the parameter controls. And the what I've found the best on this plugin is the embossing mode. Let's turn it off so you can see what is happening. And check out the edges here around the beard. And now I'm gonna crank up the embossing effect and see how you can kind of, you can see it here with the letters as well. This is beautiful, right? So this is such a cool way to bring out details inside the logo that weren't there before, but just giving those highlight during the transition is so cool. And it's so high quality. It makes my eyes want to see more of that, right? And of course, you can change the colorization amount and change the color, change the way the edge, the embossing is done. So we've got the intaglio effect here. And again, just see how that works, or invert the intaglio effect. So this is a very, very effective transition for highlighting the logos and separating out edges. See, edge highlighting and the colorization beam here, and that's so cool. So simple but effective. Let's change over to the panel wipe, and the panel wipe is basically layers of glass. And look for the panel wipe here in the effects library, panel wipe. And there you go. I'm gonna drag and drop it onto the cut and see what is happening out of the box. So there you go. You've got a beautiful single layer of glass. And when I click the transition, you've got got quite some options there. But what I'd recommend is using the surprise me button just to explore the effects, see how that works. And you can go back in time. So Command Z, Control Z for Windows. So there you go. Oh, this is beautiful, right? So see how that works. Oh, that's beautiful. And I'm just gonna reset the effect to the initial single layer of glass and show you how to change the color. And you can take the eyedropper here and make it a nice warm color and see how that works. So that's beautiful, right? And you can also change the shape of the glass. And just see how that works. And if you now find the highlights too much, just dial it back. And there you go. You've got a very clean and chic effect. And most of all, you can dial the angle. So this is so cool. So there you go. Beautiful, right? So, and let's move on to the third new tool. And this is the Glitch 2.0 Impact. And it's called 2.0 because this is actually a better version that from the glitch that we had. And so much has changed. Let's show you this using the footage I've got right here. And I'm going to look for the glitch. Glitch 2.0. And there you go. I'm going to drag and drop. Drag, drop. And see what it does out of the box. There you go. And now when I click the effect, again, I can do the surprise me just to see what kind of glitches I can make. And this is such a cool effect. And what I particularly like about this effect is that you can change the resolution of the glitch. So you've got a very coarse resolution or crank it up all the way to 100. And again, you can crunch all the different blocks here. You can increase the horizontal. I particularly like horizontal distortions on glitches. This is very effective. Let's increase the shake offset horizontal as well. Do some scaling, add more artifacts. Why not? Do some blur amount. And this is cool. Color controls are great for stylization. So if, for example, if you choose to add some kind of green color here and increase the colorization amount, see how that stylized, gives it that stylized glitched, right? And the color variation will kind of tell the plugin to look for colors around the greenish vibe here. Of course, add some chromatic aberration. That's cool. Add some contrast. Maybe do some desaturation as well. Give it some dark bars or bit flips. There you go. Play with this effect and see what happens. And right now, this is the glitch. And isn't that awesome? And again, it's great for text reveals. It's great for those music kind of vibes where you kind of want to shake things on the beat. And this is an awesome tool. And if you like these new tools, give it a big thumbs up there. And I'd recommend subscribing to our channel because we've got more videos coming up on how to use our plugins and get the most out of them. And thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. Thank you. Bye-bye.